Our country needs a new framework for growth. Given the waves of discontent passing through our country, exemplified through violent service delivery protests, it is clear that a substantial part of our society has, understandably so, become embittered not only with the excesses of in our political system, but importantly for us gathered here today, with those who hold economic power. If unchecked, this rumbling resentment and the feeling of despair could trigger populism that may reverse our democratic gains. In short, the level of inequality in our country is now an economic risk. The answer is not to close ranks and protect each other at all costs. Rather, we should foster a genuine partnership that sets us on a path to a transformed and inclusive growth. In short, when government and business sit down to talk, our conversation should be more than about business contracts. More importantly, it should be about social contract. Business must define itself as a reliable and dependable partner with government in delivering economic justice. This moment of crisis can be used to build bridges and catalyze cohesion, to drive sustainable economic outcomes for all through a public-private cooperation framework. This should be a framework that builds on the business sector and frees the market as a force for sustained economic growth, yet always striving for the public good of environmental sustainability and social inclusiveness. Equally, this framework must recognize that we are living in an innovation and artificial intelligence driven economy. Given our low ranking in digital skills, it is no exaggeration that we are unprepared for the magnitude of change that is required. The fourth industrial revolution is upon us, and it will not wait for us to find our way. We must therefore plan and plan properly for the fundamental changes it will bring on how we live and work. With the unprecedented pace of technological change, it is apparent that our system of education, transport, communication, health, and manufacturing, to name but a few, will be completely transformed from what they are today. This will require policy certainty on this front. In addition to the urgent need for developing new skills and rethinking our methods and models of education and work. Together, we must ensure a just transition to a low carbon, high tech economy. And in doing so, we must cushion the vulnerable in our midst through income and redeployment support and access to retraining opportunities. It should be clear to all our leaders by now that lifelong learning is going to be central as technology advancement creates a continuous need to upgrade skills. Our new partnership framework must ensure that nobody is left behind, and it should be anchored on political maturity and ethical conduct. In developing our framework and with a view to ensure integration with the global world, we must draw on sustainable development goals and the Paris Climate Agreement, which provide a roadmap for a zero poverty and a zero carbon world.